everyone, welcome to my virtual classroom. I hope you all are fit and fine. In today's session, we are going to learn about oral hygiene, first aid, vehicles which help us, birds, and some famous landmarks. So let us begin with the very first chapter, that is oral hygiene. We all have beautiful smiles just like this, and our sparkling white teeth makes our smile more beautiful. Our teeth are a very important part of our body. We are able to chew food with the help of our teeth to get energy. To maintain our teeth like this, we must maintain our oral hygiene. By the word oral hygiene, we mean keeping our teeth and gums as clean and healthy as possible and free of diseases. Now, how can we maintain our oral hygiene? Let us see this with a video. Whenever we eat something, bits of food get stuck in the places between our teeth. These bits remain in our mouth even after our meal is over. Now let's see what happens to this leftover food. Germs start feeding on this food and start producing acid. This acid can cause holes in our teeth called cavities. So how can we prevent such cavities? Brushing our teeth properly can keep them clean and healthy. We must brush our teeth twice a day, once in the morning and once at night. Start by cleaning the outer surface by up and down movement and then in the circular movements of the brush. Then open your mouth wide and start cleaning inner surface and tongue of your mouth too. Clean the biting surface of teeth with back and forth movement. Then rinse your mouth with water and make sure you don't swallow the toothpaste. We must be careful of what we eat and drink too. Germs in our mouth love sugary food. So avoid eating those. Visit for a dental checkup at least once a year. Now, let us do book exercise. The very first question is, what causes tooth decay? The answer to this question is acid. At what age should a child visit a dentist? He must visit when he is of 1 year old. Toothbrushes should be replaced every 2 to 3 months. Which is the hardest tissue in our body? Enamel is the hardest tissue in our body. Tooth decay is also called cavity. Now let's move on to the next chapter, that is first aid and rescue. We all love to play, we all love to ride bicycles, do craft work, right? But these activities sometimes lead to an accident. Whenever we get hurt, we need special care and attention. The first help which we get whenever any such thing happens is called first aid. It is the first help that can be provided to a sick or an injured person when proper medical care is not available. It is important as it offers immediate help to a sick or an injured person, which can help minimize the harm to the person. So let us know how can we make our own first aid kit. To make our own first aid kit, we will need few things. The very first thing is antiseptic. We might need a Dettol or a Savlon. Then we need a spirit or rubbing alcohol. An antiseptic cream like Betadine or Soframycin. Some cotton balls. A roller gauze. Then we are going to need some band-aids for small bruises. An ORS solution so that we could rehydrate ourselves. Few tablets like paracetamol. A plaster or a doctor's tape. And lastly, a pair of scissors. Ta-da! Our first aid kit is ready. Now let's see what our book exercise is about. So here we have to select few items from which we can make our own first aid kit. So the very first item, that is a roller bandage, it is already ticked. Now the second object is stethoscope. We will not be needing any stethoscope, so we have put a cross. Then an antiseptic cream. We are not going to need any gloves. We will need a bandage, so we have put a tick. We might need a thermometer also. The next object is injections. We will not be using it. An antiseptic like Dettol. And the last one is a BP machine. We might not be needing it. So we have put across to the things which are not needed in a first aid box. Here we have a small incident where there are different steps which we will take while providing first aid to Ria. So we have to take an antiseptic on a piece of cotton wool. Then we have to apply pressure on the wound until the bleeding stops. Second step is to apply ointment on the wound. Third step is wrap a piece of cotton wool. Cotton wool means the cotton balls we have in our hands. So we have to apply that on the bandage to cover the wound. Now cover the wound with a bandage cotton piece created in step 3. And the last step is to keep it in a place using a surgical tape. Surgical tape and doctor's tape is one and the same thing. The next chapter, that is chapter 5, vehicles that help us. We all have seen vehicles like cars, buses, cycles, trains, vans, on land. There are few transports that help us apart from transporting. Can you name them? So today we are going to learn about the vehicles that help us. The very first one is a firefighting bus. It has water stored inside it, which helps the firefighters to put out fires. It also has a long ladder that firefighters use to reach high buildings. Now the second vehicle is an ambulance. It helps us to transport sick people to the hospital quickly. It has a siren on top to alert everyone to make way for it. Now the third vehicle is a police car. It helps the police to chase bad people. To call one of these special vehicles, we have some special numbers. For example, to call an ambulance, we must dial 102. To call a firefighting truck, we should call 101. And to call police, we have to call 100. So students, make sure you remember all these numbers in case whenever you need it. Now the next chapter is chapter 9, birds that cannot fly. There are 10,000 species of birds in the world. Many of them can fly, but some of them cannot. Apart from this special ability to fly, there are certain birds who can speak, who can fly high, who have the longest wingspans. So let's read about such birds. Kiwi is the bird which is found in New Zealand. It sleeps at daytime and hunts for food at night. This bird cannot fly. The second bird is penguin. It is also a flightless marine bird. It is found in southern hemisphere and it can swim and dive. So this bird penguin, it do has wings, but with the help of these wings, It can swim and dive. It cannot fly. Now the third bird is emu. Emu is a flightless bird found in Australia. It is the second largest bird after ostrich. The last bird is ostrich. As I told you, it is the first largest, heaviest and largest bird. It is found in Africa. Moving on to the last chapter, chapter 11, world famous landmarks. There are many landmarks around the world that are famous even outside the country where they are located. So let us learn some of these landmarks. We have India Gate in India, Statue of Unity in Gujarat in India. Then moving on to the book exercise, the very first one is, it is a 21,186 kilometers long wall. This is the Great Wall of China. It is 2700 years old and acts as a huge barrier crossing 15 regions of North China. The second picture is of the Statue of Liberty. It is a monument of national importance in the United States. It was gifted to USA by France. The third picture is of Eiffel Tower. It is located in the city of Paris and it took 2 years, 2 months and 5 days for its construction. The last famous landmark is Leaning Tower of Pisa. It is a bell tower which is leaning at an angle of 4 degrees. Due to an unstable foundation. So for today's session, this is it. I hope you have learned quite a few things. Till then, be safe, be at your home. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.